In this video, I'm gonna show you how I create custom AI agent teams to do the work for me. Specifically, in this tutorial, we will create a custom AI agency that develops responsive web applications using Next.js and Material UI. But the best part about this tutorial is that most of the work was actually done by AI rather than by myself. Yes, almost anyone can now create their own custom AI agent teams just by chatting with the Genesys agency that creates your agents for you. So, whether you're an AI developer or an entrepreneur, this video will show you how to create those custom agent swarms for your or your client's business. Let's dive in. Okay, so let's check this out live. Let me know what you guys think about the new format. And now you can basically use the Genesys agency directly from your CLI to get started much faster. Simply run agency swarm Genesys command, and this will activate the Genesys agency directly in your terminal. So then you can just say, like, I need a web development agency. So I've prepared this prompt in advance, and I'm just gonna say that the goal is to develop responsive web applications using Next.js and MUI, which is what we use in our agency, and that the CEO must communicate with the designer, who communicates with the web developer and copywriter, and then I'm also describing which tools each agent must use. Perfect, so now it proposes the initial structure for my agency exactly like I described, with the Genesys CEO who communicates with the designer, who then communicates with the web developer and copywriter. It also defines some initial goals, mission, processes for my agency, and then asks me to confirm if this aligns with my vision, which it does, so I'm just gonna tell it to proceed. Awesome, so first the Genesys CEO creates the agency folder for my agency, which you can see right here on the left with the agency manifesto, and then it proceeds with telling the agent creator to create the first agent. After the designer agent has been created, which you can also see on the left, it proceeds with telling the tool creator agent to create tools for this agent. As you can see, the tool creator then creates the first tool, which is the browser analysis tool, which uses beautiful soup by default. We might want to adjust this later, but so far it looks pretty good. It then proceeds with testing the tool, but as you can see, it encounters an error because non-type object has no attribute loader. I suppose this is because the beautiful soup is not installed yet. So let's see what happens next. Okay, it then tells the agent creator that there was an error, which it then tells the COO agent. Then the COO agent tells the agent creator to create the next agent, which is the web developer agent. So here are the web developer agent's instructions. The first tool that it creates is called the directory navigator tool. And as you can see, it simply uses the OS change dir method, which is probably how I would implement this tool as well. And then it also creates a file reader tool, which simply opens the file using Python, reads the content, and then returns it. This actually looks pretty good already, so I don't think there are even any modifications required just yet. And then it also creates the file writer tool, which takes the file path, the content as a string, and then it opens this file, and then returns the confirmation as the tool output. Then it tells the agent creator that all of the tools were successfully created. One tool we didn't check out is a comment executor tool, which uses subprocess with the command. This could be dangerous, so we might want to modify this later. Perfect, so now the Genesys CEO tells me that the WebCrafters agency has been successfully established. However, it seems like the Genesys CEO forgot to create the copywriter agent, but now we can easily fix this with the new mentions feature that I have added to this framework. Now, when creating your agency, you can add multiple agents as the entry points for communication. So in the top level array, you can now include multiple agents, not just the CEO agent, and then the user will be able to communicate directly with those agents. The way you use this tool is simply add an at sign and then name the agent that you want to talk with, followed by the message to this agent. So I'm gonna say to the agent creator to create the copywriter agent. As you can see, the thread is now between me and the agent creator instead of the Genesys CEO, which speeds up the communication flow. So now the agent creator tells me that the copywriter agent has been created, and you can see it on the left with the instructions files defined accordingly. Then the CEO tells me that we can run this agency with the Python agency.py command. So let's try this out. Let's cd into the web dev crafters agency and then simply run Python agency.py. Cool, so now it opens up a link with the Gradio. First of all, you can now upload files, you can select which agent you are talking with, but as I said before, you do have to add those agents right here. So if you add like another agent like this in the top level array, you will be able to communicate with it as well directly. So let me rerun the agency.py command with the designer in the top level array as well and just show you how this works. All right, cool. So now as you can see in the recipient agent, you can also select the designer, not just the CO agent. And then let's just try to say hi, for example. Cool. So now we get a response from the designer directly. But before we actually run this agency and try to create our first website, we do need to make a few adjustments because I certainly do not want the web developer agent to execute any commands on my PC. So let's quickly go through all of these tools, starting with the web developer and then adjust them accordingly. So the command executor tool, I'm going to rename into simply run command. Then I'm going to define all of the commands that this agent can run in advance. This way we can ensure that our agent does not execute anything unexpected. For the commands field, I'm going to define a couple of options using a literal type. The first one will be build and the second one will be create next app. Then I'm going to adjust the execution logic to execute only certain commands based on the input from the agent. So if the command is create next app, we're just going to run npx create next app. And if the command is build, we're going to run npm run build. So this tools directory is a new addition to my framework where essentially all the tools that you put in this folder will automatically be imported by your agents to use. All you have to do is specify the tools folder when initializing your agent. Additionally, don't forget to rename the file so it matches the name of your tool, otherwise it will not be imported. So the rest of the tools for the web developer agent actually look pretty good, but I do want to add one extra tool that would allow this agent to browse the current directory and see what files are inside. I'm gonna call this tool list dir. This tool will essentially just take a dir path and then return the current directory tree as a string. And finally, I also want to modify the browser analysis tool for the designer agent because I do not want this agent to read the whole HTML of the web page since HTML contains a lot of useless information. Instead, I want to use a tool similar to the one I've created in my browsing agent video that will take the screenshot of the current web page and then analyze it with GPT-4V. So how this tool will function is it will open the localhost URL with the 3000 port where the next application will be hosted. Then it will get the screenshot of the current browser window and use GPT-4V with a special prompt to analyze this screenshot. So the designer agent will be able to use this tool to check if the current web page aligns with the provided design. Now let's go ahead and adjust some instructions for our agents. For example, I want to ensure that the web developer agent understands that it first needs to serve the web page before submitting the work to the designer so the designer can analyze it later. And I'm just going to include this in the primary tasks. Okay, so finally we're ready to test this. To run your agency, simply execute the agency.py file. In the first message, I'm just going to say that I need a new website for my AI development agency, Arsen AI. Then the CO immediately tells the designer agent to create a compelling copy and the design for my agency. Awesome, so now we get a complete copy for my new website with a cool headline revolutionizing your business through AI development and a copy for each section. What's funny is that it actually ends on the exact same phrase that I have on my current website, which is ready to transform your business ? Cool, so then the CO agent wants to confirm if this design aligns with my vision, which it does, so I'm gonna tell it to proceed with the development. Obviously, this is just my prompt. You can adjust the instructions for each agent accordingly. In my case, I was constantly iterating on the system, running those agents and adjusting the instructions and tools accordingly until this agency performed the tasks as I expected. As you can see now, the web developer agent gets the first task to develop the hero section and then it executes the first command to create Next.js application, which we should now see on the left. Yes, so as you can see, we now got the Arsen AI folder with some Next.js boilerplate code. And then the agent proceeds with installing some additional requirements, which are Material UI, Emotion, and Emotion Styled. This is because in my agency manifesto, I said that I want to use Material UI for the development. Okay, cool. So now our agent created the first component in the components folder with our copy, unleash the power of artificial intelligence. Then it should proceed with importing this component into the index.tsx file, as you can see right here. Then it builds our application and reports back to the designer, who then sends a new section for the development. We can also check the progress locally if we navigate into our new Next.js app directory and then run the development server with npm run dev command. Awesome, so this is what our website looks like right now. Seems like we're still using Next.js styles, but we can fix this later. The next section that our agent has just created is our mission section, which you can also see in the components folder on the left. It also uses some icons from Material UI icons package. However, it seems like the build fails because currently this package is not installed. So then web developer performs the next command to install Material UI icons package, which is now added into the package JSON. Then the app builds successfully. Okay, pretty cool. I mean, yeah, we're getting somewhere. The next section that our designer sends to the web developer is expertise across industries section with, you know, some basic layout, visual elements, and text content. Awesome, so we got this new component with also some icons from Material UI. Okay, as you can see, the expertise is now also added to our landing page. Let's check it out. Oops, so we have to rebuild the website, apparently. All right, so this is what we got now. Seems like there are some issues with styling, but we can probably fix this later. Awesome, now finally the web development agent creates the final section, which is the footer section with some contact information, and then it also adds it to the index.tsx file. So now we have this nice footer and our landing page is pretty much complete. I mean, I understand that it's not quite there yet, but the fact that this whole landing page was developed by AI that in fact was created by another AI, that's pretty cool. And actually we can make it much better just by adding some themes from Material UI. Awesome, so the styling of our website already looks much better, the colors seem to be fixed, and the only problem that I can still see right here is that the contact section is kind of broken and the button should definitely not be here, so let's just task our web developer with fixing this final section. So then the CEO tells that the client has reported that the layout of the contact us section is still broken. It's funny that it actually refers to me as to a client because of how we defined the agency manifesto. Awesome, so now it seems like it rewrote the whole contact us section and now it is using a grid, which is a responsive component from Material UI, which means that most likely our app is now going to look much better. It's pretty cool that you can use this agency kind of like as your pair programmer and just converse back and forth with it and at the same time work on those files. As you can see, it again runs into a build issue, seems like it inappropriately used change lines tool. And here, as you can see, actually in this run command tool, I'm including some special instructions at the end of the function output in case if the command fails. And specifically, I'm telling this agent to rewrite the entire file with the file writer tool in case if it gets stuck. So I found that, you know, providing those instructions depending on specific conditions in your tools allows you to much better control your system. So as you can see, now it rewrites the whole file just as I instructed and then builds the web application. Perfect, so this is what our website looks like now. As you can see, the styling is much better. The form is also not broken any longer. The contact us text is below the ready to transform your business text, just as I requested. And let's see if this is actually responsive. Yep, as you can see, the whole application is pretty much responsive. There are some issues with styling, but of course you can fix this pretty fast. So yeah, all the code for this agency will be on a new repository that I created on GitHub called Agency Swarm Lab. In this repository, we will keep adding more and more agencies created with Agency Swarm for various use cases. So if you have any cool use cases that you've made before, feel free to contribute. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.